Driving the Tesla Model 3 was a really fun and high-tech experience. One thing that really stuck out to me and felt unique was that when you get into the vehicle, there's essentially no dashboard. All of the car is controlled essentially from what looks like a large tablet in the center. Another thing that I really loved about the Tesla was the acceleration. You push on the pedal and you really know that vehicle's going. It really takes off. And I really like the noise factor. It's absolutely silent. There's no sound coming out of these electric vehicles. So it just makes for a quiet, peaceful driving experience.
I did not anticipate how much I would enjoy it. It is fun, it is quick. You know, my family loves it, and I love especially not driving a gas guzzler. My last car was a Chevy Tahoe, and to go from getting 16 miles a gallon to getting the equivalent of 90 miles a gallon is really a lot of fun.
Charging the Tesla Model 3 was a way different experience than what I'm used to when I go to the gas station to fill up my conventional vehicle. We actually had the opportunity to take it to a supercharger, which was really cool. So once we plugged it into the supercharger, it was accepting a charge at a rate of 523 kilowatts per hour. We actually had 23 minutes to charge before it was ready for us to go. So that's a really short period of time. Charging a Tesla on a level 2 is also super easy. Denver has a plethora of level 2 chargers that are public accessible. You can find those on various different apps and websites. If you have a garage or somewhere where you park that has access to just a regular 3-prong plug, a lot of people don't know that you can actually charge your vehicle in that plug as well. Do your 8 hours of sleeping inside and come out and your vehicle's fully charged and ready to go.
I did have terrible range anxiety when I first got it. Every chance I got, I would charge it. But then I realized 300 miles is a really long way. And you'll realize that charging at home at night, especially if you drive 30, 40 miles a day, it's not a big deal.
I think one of the biggest barriers we have to overcome when it comes to electric vehicle adoption is this perception that it's a rich people technology. In recent years, we've seen the prices go lower and lower on electric vehicles, and we've seen the used electric vehicle market start to develop as well. Colorado has a great tax incentive. So you get a $4,000 tax credit if you purchase an electric vehicle in Colorado before January 1st, 2021. This is a technology for everyone. If you have access to a simple plug that you plug your laptop into, you can charge your electric vehicle. So once people start to understand that and then actually get behind the wheel of one, they'll fall in love just like everyone who already has one, and we'll start to see even more of them on the road.
Clean air in Colorado is really important to me, as I know it is to a lot of people. And one thing that I know I can do is drive an EV really does contribute to clean air quality.
I think it's important that the Denver Metro residents and Coloradoans in general make it a goal to work towards adopting electric vehicles and zero emission technology. We know now that electric vehicles are becoming more easily accessible and affordable. We should absolutely be trying to adopt this technology and work towards cleaning up the air in Colorado.
Check out a Tesla at one of the Tesla facilities. Check out any other EV. They're all great to drive.
Get in touch with us at Denver Metro Clean Cities. If you're interested in adopting electric vehicle, we are here to help coach you along in that process and help you find what works best for you and your needs and your lifestyle.
So please go to our website, driveelectriccolorado.org, and take the Be In Charge pledge to make your next car electric.